This is a golden tree snake, Chrysopelea ornata, and it has caught itself a Tokay gecko. These snakes frequently hunt geckos. And it's just an incredible source of wonderment and amazement to me that this very slim, agile, climbing snake is able to swallow a gecko of this size. But they obviously do, as you will see shortly. This is on the steps leading to the ladies' bathroom here in the campsite at Kaeng Krachan National Park. Unfortunately for my wife, we were just packing up to leave the park when she thought she would go to the bathroom, and then I heard that kind of scream that I know can only mean one thing, and so I prepared to set up my camera equipment to come and film. The Tokay has already died. It's clearly immobile now. There are clips that I have seen previously of monumental battles between Tokay geckos and golden tree snakes, where the gecko has managed to get a bite on the snake and neither of them is prepared to let go. And I know those battles can go on for a long, long time. In this case, clearly the snake has killed the Tokay before I've got here, and is slowly, very, very slowly setting about the process of swallowing this gecko. It will get stuck at the shoulders of the front legs and the back legs. That part of the swallowing process seems to take a long time, not surprisingly. This is a mildly venomous snake, of no danger at all to humans. They do have fangs at the rear of the mouth that are grooved and down which a mild venom flows into the victim, presumably to help subdue it during the capture and swallowing process. At times here we can see that there is a certain amount of liquid on the body of the Tokay in the corner of the snake's mouth, and I wonder if this is fluid coming from the Tokay or whether this is the venom that has leaked out of those back fangs of the snake. Golden tree snakes are widespread in Southeast Asia, and I've found them in every part of Thailand. It's one of the snakes I see most frequently. Perhaps that's also because they are active in the daytime. And also, you can find them in cities. I've many times found them in Bangkok, even quite close to the center of Bangkok. They eat a variety of prey items. In addition to these Tokays, they'll eat other kinds of lizards, apparently rodents, and even other kinds of snakes as well, although I've not seen that personally. I have seen one enter a nest quite high up in a tree and clearly swallow either hatchlings or eggs, although I suspect it was young birds that it was taking from that nest, despite being mobbed by the parent birds, and very interestingly by many other kinds of birds as well. There were many birds that were clearly concerned about having that snake there, even though it wasn't their nest, and they all kind of joined in and tried to drive it away unsuccessfully, I must say. And in other locations I've also seen birds, particularly minor birds, get very agitated if they see one of these golden tree snakes in their vicinity. Small individuals of this species seem to have a relatively mild disposition, but large ones, fully grown adults, have always been very aggressive in my experience, and will strike and bite readily. Just look at the way that the neck of this snake has been able to expand to perhaps two or three times its normal size. Those scales that we can see there would normally be overlapping, but they're clearly mounted on a flexible skin underneath that has pulled apart to allow this Tokay gecko to pass down the otherwise narrow, normally narrow, neck of this snake. You can see there are a number of black bands on the head of this snake, and you can see those bands very clearly on a shed skin. So it's quite helpful if you find skin in and around your house. If you live in Asia, this is one of the snakes that you can very easily identify from the shed skin. I have a house in the countryside, and have a lot of this species living in a hollow wall in that house, and there's one particularly big one there. Although it's supposed to grow up to about 1.30 meters in length, I measured a skin from that individual at 1.70 meters. Now, skin stretches when snakes shed the skin, and depending on how fresh it is, that stretch apparently might be between 10% and 30% over the actual length of the snake. So that might suggest a snake close to around about 1.30 meters to 1.40 meters. This group of snakes, this genus that the golden tree snake belongs to, are also sometimes called flying snakes. Now, they can't fly in the true sense of the word, but they can glide, and they do this by pulling their belly scales into a concave shape and basically swimming through the air. They leap out of one tree, perhaps into another, or even down onto the ground. And although this is normally over short distances, there have been some instances measured apparently up to 100 meters. I'm not sure with this particular species or with one of the other ones. At times the snake appears a little agitated. It's very hot, and you can see sometimes it's positioned in a bit of shade on these steps, but also at other times it's out in the full sun. And there are also a number of large red ants that I think are biting the snake at times. And I can tell you from personal experience that a combination of those biting red ants and the blazing Thai sun is enough to make anybody irritable. And I'm sure this snake wants to get on with this and get away as quickly as possible. I have cut this video down to only about 9 minutes, but the entire process actually took a full hour before that tail finally slid into the snake's mouth, and then it slowly made its way away and then went vertically up a tree, even with this large Tokay in its belly. It was able to climb. They are phenomenal climbers and escape artists extraordinaire.